明日の天気はどうでしょう。
寒い
でしょう。明日の天気も寒いでしょう。Or you can make a guess。ちょっとスマホで調べなくていいです。はい、guess。You can make a guess。暖かいかもしれません。ちょっと言いましょう。暖かいかもしれません。
暖かいかもしれません。
はい、ちょっと元気がないですね。はい、じゃあ寒いでしょうか。寒いでしょうか明日。寒いかもしれません。そうですね。じゃあちょっと言いますよ。寒いかもしれません。寒いかもしれません。はい、いいですね。じゃあ先生、昨日どうしたでしょうか。先生は昨日何をしたでしょうか。いいですね。働きすぎたかもしれません。それからこっちなんか全然言わないですね。先生は昨日どうしたでしょう。寝ない。
寝なかった
かもしれません。寝なかったかもしれません。何をしたかもしれませんか昨日。何でしょう。セイさん、あ、ビールを飲んだかもしれませんね。 Maybe drunk too much。 飲みすぎたかもしれませんね。先生、ビールを飲みすぎたかもしれません。でもね、先生ビール飲みません。好きじゃありませんから。はい、でもワインが好きですね。ワインとオレンジジュースをミックスする、はい、ですからちょっとワインを、ね、飲みすぎたかもしれません。はい、いいです。じゃあですね、今日の漢字の勉強をしましょう。はい、今日の漢字はこれですね。 We actually don't have any word to use this 漢字 but remember the concept and the shape also。 You know this kanji already, so you can combine these two to mean the center. So they both mean center, but middle and the center, which is the center. And what's the difference from mannaka, which uses mannaka to mean the center? Mannaka is more casual word compared to chuo, which is the very formal word to mean center. The idea of kanji, well, according to Kanji no Katsuran, is Superman.But I found that something really interesting. Which one? This kanji came from the concept of the pillory docks. Right. And like in ancient times, how could people say, you know, we need a pictorial symbol for center? Okay, let's use this.
Well, because at the center of town, you put the stocks in there, so it's like humiliated because everyone's in there.
Yeah, but then that's a meeting. Would you?Yeah, center of that, as a good book, actually, yes. Not just the center of the city.
日本語で昔の歌詞、ストークスを使いましたか？
中国で使いましたね。日本でもあったと思います。はい。でも、中国ですから、ちょっと中国の人。なんでですか？なんでですか？うん。面白いから。
So
on the quiz, you will have the kanji and the meaning in English, for example. So it's turned into this shape, like a hieroglyph shape, and then the kanji. Right? Well, the reason we are learning this is basically to learn the next kanji, which is e, as in eiga. So, I didn't really write the previous one either. So we go back to this O, which starts with the line here, and then you need to make a sort of square shape first. And then this line stick out, all right? Make sure that it's different from the square shape in, you know, Naka. And then you need to put a person, you know, to to be inside here. Alright? So this will be the O as you can see. で、ちょっと一緒に書きましょう。いいですか？はい。1、2、and then 3、4、5。はい、いいです。So we'll use this kanji to write the next kanji. いいですか？ This is really the combination of the sun and then、the sinner or something that maybe takes light because of the light. Oh, that's a nice way to remember. See? We use this kanji for 映画 and that's going to be the only word that we can use the kanji for at this point. But if you are interested, then you can also use the kanji for the word usuru or utsusu to project like images on screen. And you need to remember this word, 映画 as in 映画. And then when you write that kanji, then you need to start with the vertical, which is the san. So, ichi, ni, san, yon. And then put the center here. This name. じゃあちょっと一緒に書いてみましょう。いいですか? First step is the vertical.1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. はい、でちょっとノートに書きましょう。ですね、there are several different kanji for 写す to copy, to take a photograph, and then to project. A lot of different words, yeah, different kinds of like.Showing, like projecting an image. And we use different kanji for them. So you don't need to remember, but then you do need to remember the utsusu in this way, right? This is utsusu. Like, shashin wo utsusu, to take a photograph. And this is the kanji you need to remember. はい、じゃあ次の漢字ですね。This one we are going to use in 映画. So put them together.This time we really have only one word to remember with the kanji. The kanji for ga means picture, drawings originally, and it came from the combination of this kanji, which is to write or draw, and then what would you draw? Usually it's a rice paddy drawing, so combine them together, and then because it's a picture, add a frame around it, and then.We have too much on the top of the kanji, so let's just delete it. And then this is probably the Chinese version, right? Yeah. Make sure, especially for the Chinese speakers here, that you have the line in between, right? It's connected. So how would you write this kanji? Then start with the line on the top, and then you need to finish the rice paddy here.And then also remember that this is one line. It needs to start here and go down. And then end it. And then add the frame around the rice field like this. Okay? So here, it's connected. It's all one line. はい、いいです。じゃあ一緒に書きましょう。いいかな?はい。1、2、3。And then 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 8. はい、いいです。じゃあちょっと漢字を書きましょう。ノートに書いて。いいですね。じゃあ明日の漢字クイズはこれですね。はい、じゃあ今日の文法の勉強をしましょう。これですね。 先生ちょっと簡単にレビューをします。いいですか。質問があったら聞いてください。This, we have three words that we've learned so far to express giving and receiving of things and gifts. But idea is that often we need the concept of I or watashi to start with to express this. So there's another person to give or to receive from. Let's say X and Y there, then for the convenience. これは?How do you express it? X は listen, what would be the verb?
Wine.
Oh, watashi. Agemashita. Agemasu ですね。これです。Ageru would be the action. And then you need X, Y, ni as particles. Now, when you need to put an object in a sentence, then present or what's a particle?
Go.
Oh, いいですね。X は Y にプレゼントをあげる、あげます。はい、じゃあ、オポです。この
Y が
プレゼント。くれる?それから?もらう。はい。くれる、もらう。ね。This can be described by two verbs, but then you have different subject of the sentence. Y は X にくれる。Right? And then X は Y から Y にもらう。大丈夫ですね。いい?はい。Also, the interesting thing about Japanese culture is that often we have more expanded sense of self with the like, family members and friends included. This category of my uchi group or my inside member group, depending on the situation, the context, then the border of this will change. So it can be like family members or sometimes it can be your closer friends in contrast to other friends. So depending on this, we might actually have a different sense of me or watashi, like as a category. And then when, for example, the gift is given to somebody else in this group, then still this person will be treated as part of me. So just consider as like this whole category as me. If the gift giving, like giving and receiving, happens between someone in the group and outside the group. So this will be something a little unique to Japanese culture. 大丈夫? Also, the giving and receiving can take place between two people who are maybe equally unrelated to you. Then, これは? X は Y に お? X は Y にうん。あげるですね。あげる。それから、これは?
もらう?
はい。もらう派がくれる。
いえ。
はい。いえ、くれるは使いません。So, もらう、くれる is really an action involving me. In this case, もらう would be the verb to use. X は Y に、or Y からもらう。ですね。大丈夫ね。いい。質問はありますか?はい、どうぞ。
Textbook, it kind of indicated that you could use kureru.
Kureru as like give you?
Yeah.
Ignore it.
Okay.
I'll just remove it. That looks like a mistake, like the last sentence, right? In the kureru, right?
But they had like this whole diagram that was really confusing and it seemed it was like they kind of mixed the giving and receiving verbs, so it was just really complex. It's like if you change the particles, then it's like just the reverse. I don't know. It was just right.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Right. And I would say here in the textbook, then as an example, English example of kureru, then you have somebody gives you.
Yeah.
And then I would say this is just really confusing and almost wrong. Yeah. So I would say that's not one you should ignore. Like it shouldn't be included even there. Right. And the question is really, kureru is kind of a unique concept involving basically me in here. So the easiest way to remember these words is really this. If it's give, ageru, this action, ageru. Then receive, morau. And then here it's a little bit hello, but then give me, or me including someone in my group, right? Then that will be kureru. So these three, that's all. Not much.
So if I give something to my mother, I could use kureru.
No,
your no, mother gives you. If my mother gives, okay,
yeah.
Never mind.
Right. So or, in that case, then you, like myself, and then somebody else.
So if like somebody else gives something to my mother, could I use kureru?
ちょっとね、それやってみましょう. はい、ちょっとね、見てみましょう. No, this will answer your question actually. 私がいますね. And then there are three people. Hondaさんです。これは?
山口さん。ね、Hondaさん。
じゃあ、これはどうですか? So we have three choices, right? 山口さん、私。 Then make up sentence.
私は、
Then let's start with 私は山口さん。 え、待って。私は山口さんに本をもらいました。 One more sentence you can make. 山口さんが私に本をくれました。いいですね。 So in this, then you don't use あげる. But then you have two choices. じゃあですね、もう一ついきます。これ Then, once again, three verbs that you could use.
私は本田さんに花をあげました。
Any other choice?
本田さんは
あ、私に花をもらいました。 And that makes sense. We just don't use that expression. もらう is more like I receive from outside a person. So I would say in this context, then あげる would be the only choice almost. Because もらう is more like I receive or if it's happening like, between the two. And then もらう is okay too. But then if I is involved, then I wouldn't say もらう just doesn't work. But it makes sense grammatically, correct? Contextually wrong.
Shima-san. Is the name Honda-san where the car brand Honda comes from?
そうです。知りませんでしたか? Honda-san, Toyota-san も 名前です。 Toyota-wa Richfield, Toyota. Honda is Honda.
You couldn't use like morau to emphasize like they received it from you instead of like you gave it to them.
In a very specific context, then for example, Yang Yi-san has my smartphone. And I'm like, "私のスマートフォンどこですか?" あ、そこにありますね。 And then, ちょっと 誰にもらいましたか? So the question is, received from whom? Then, Yang Yi-san は私にもらいました。 Then in a very limited, specific context that could happen, I can see. Hi. And the other words, just to describe, I wouldn't say that. Just doesn't happen. はい、質問ありますか? 大丈夫? じゃあ、be with these two people too. This can happen too. はい? Then once again, you have three choices. So, じゃあ、山口さんは、本田さんに、
自転車を、はい、あげました。もう一つ。本田さんは山口さんに自転車をもらいました。
はい、いいですね。In this case, くれる does not work, right? because it doesn't involve me. I guess. Also, to answer Shima-san's question, ne, within the family too, there's giving receiving too. Ne, これ、お母さんですね。母です。弟です。いいですか？
あの、in the textbook, it says that if someone receives something that then directly affects you, you can use kureru. So like, if someone gave my mom like concert tickets for the entire family, I can use kureru.
Hi. I can do that with another example too. But first, let's do this too. So mother gives money to me, then どうでしょう？母が私にお金をくれました。じゃあ今度は私は私は母にお金をもらいました。はい、いいです。Then to answer ビタマンズさんのクエスチョンはあげるようになった。ワンモア。じゃあこれはどうですか？母は山口さんにお茶をあげました。うん。Anything else?あげました。はい。
Can you use
morai? No. Morai doesn't work, and it's about the same here. はい。いいですね。だからこれですね。本田さん、and giving something to 弟。But then 弟 is one of your family members. どうでしょう。Then 本田さんは弟に。これおもちゃ、うん、おもちゃをくれました。はい、くれました。 It works the same as here、ね、くれました。じゃあ弟は、弟は本田さんにおもちゃをもらいました。うん、大丈夫かな、なんとなくMaking sense. はい、いいです。ちょっとね、難しいですね。はい、